Hey guys, welcome back. Today we'll be discussing about compensating curves part 2. In previous part we have discussed about antero-posterior curve, that is curve of SPI, in detail. So if you have not seen that video, do see that. Link is given in the description, as well as you can press the I button for the same. Switching on to part 2 today, that is medial lateral curves, the curves which run from side to side. So in that we have curve of Wilson and curve of Monson today. So switching on to curve of Wilson first. So curve of Wilson was given in the year 1911 by George Wilson. So he was searching something in order to avoid the posterior teeth interferences. So he gave the concept of curve of Wilson. So what is that concept, we'll see first. So we'll see the figure. In the figure, these are the first premolar maxillary, and these are the mandibular molars, say first molars. This is the buccal cusp, and this is the palatal cusp, and this is the mesial surface of the tooth. Whereas this is also the mesial surface of the first molar. This is buccal cusp, lingual cusp, buccal cusp, and lingual cusp. Now we all know that the lower posterior teeth are slightly lingually inclined. Now if we see from the mesial view, and if we draw a line touching the buccal and lingual cusp of both the sides, we would get somewhat this shape. Now seeing this, the lower posteriors are inclined lingually slightly, as we can see in this case. So we get something which is concave or convex downwards. So the shape of the curve is concave, or it is convex downwards. So this is the curve of Wilson for lower posteriors. If we observe the first premolars, in that case we usually see that the buccal cusp are always higher than the palatal cusp. In this case, the direction of the curve is exactly opposite. If we draw the line, so this is convex upwards, whereas in lower posterior it was convex downwards. So the curve of Wilson direction for the upper posterior is convex upwards, whereas for lower posterior it is concave or convex downwards. So it the direction usually results because of the inclination of the teeth. Coming on to importance of curve of Wilson. So as we have already seen that curve of Wilson, it is concave in mandibular posterior teeth and convex in maxillary posterior teeth, especially premolars. We know that lower posterior teeth are slightly lingually inclined, but then why we need that position for the mandibular posterior teeth? Now lower posterior teeth are lingually inclined, so as they are lingually inclined, this makes them parallel to the elevator muscle pull direction. As they become parallel to that of elevator muscle pull direction, this provides resistance to loading and occlusal forces. Now moving on to second function, that is enabling mastication of the food. Now we will see how does this lingual inclination of the lower posterior teeth helps in the mastication of the food. So this is bolus of the food. Now because of the lingual inclination, the lingual cusp seems to be shorter, whereas buccal cusp seems to be taller. So during mastication, the tongue can easily pass on the food bolus over the occlusal surface, as the lingual cusp seems to be shorter. Whereas once the bolus comes over the occlusal surface, as the buccal cusp seems to be taller, buccal cusp prevents the bolus of the food to get trapped into the buccal sulcus. So in this way, the lingual inclination of the mandibular posterior teeth, it helps in enabling the mastication of the food. Turning on to third function, so the inclination of the posterior teeth, it always prevents any type of interferences in the posterior teeth to occur during any type of excursion, that is protrusive excursion or lateral excursion. We want to curve of Monson. So it is the curve of occlusion in which each cusp and incisal edge, it conforms to a segment of surface of a sphere. So surface of the sphere, which is 8 inches in diameter, with its center in the region of glabella. Hence curve of Monson, it is the curve which forms by the connection of both curve of Wilson and curve of SPI. So in 1920, Monson, he connected the curve of Wilson and curve of SPI to all cusps and incisal edges, which formed a sphere of 8 inches diameter.
And he also stated that mandibular arch adapted itself to the curved segment of the sphere. So in the figure we can see that curve of Monson, it connects both the curve of Spee as well as the curve of Wilson.
So hope you like the video, guys. If you like the video, please like, share and subscribe my channel Akshay Bhandari's Dental Video. See you in the next video. Thank you.